All right, what's up, guys, and welcome back to Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag. So I've been playing off camera for about 3.5, possibly 4 hours today, and I've noticed several things. First and foremost, my ship was really crappy. We were very, very underleveled, very underpowered, if that makes any sense. And two, the ship wars, the ship battles in this game are surprisingly amazing. I've been hearing this for a long time, but when you start getting into different ships and bigger ships, things start changing, and it's kind of like this addicting type of feeling that you get. I mean, I probably could have been done about 2.5 hours, but I just kept playing and playing because I was seeing bigger and bigger and bigger ships, and I don't know. It was just absolutely fun, and I have to say hats off to the team. They did such a fantastic thing. I also noticed that the bigger the ships, the more things you have to do to take them out once you hijack the ships. You know, the bigger they are, the more crew members you got to take down. Then some of them you even have to take out, like the hunters up top with snipers or, you know, whatever it is, the weapons that they have. The muskets. Some of the ships, you even have to go all the way to the tippity top of the ship and cut off the flag, which I thought was super, super cool. I think we're definitely ready to sail the seas within these main missions. I felt like we were very, very, very underpowered, and sometimes I was trying to avoid certain ships just to not get, you know, killed. But I feel like now I feel very confident. I know we've got like 3-4 more sequences, and I feel like we are A-okay. I feel like we could take on a lot of different ships. Or so I have on my own time here off camera. But thank you guys for recommending me to do more ship battles and upgrade the ship. We're not all the way up there, but we're much better than we were about 4 hours ago. Okay, and that's all good and gravy. Now, we haven't really upgraded Edward much because we have to like skin animals, and we really haven't done that. So we'll see if we'll do that along the way of this episode. If not, I'll do some of that off camera as well, so we can kind of be up to par. But I felt like the ship was more important because at least for the character, I have a little bit more control of whether I can die or not versus the ship. When you get attacked by multiple ships, you're done. Anyways, we are back today sailing the seas with our pirates. And yeah. So by the way, not only did we take down ships, but we also conquered some forts. I conquered this one as well here to the left. And this is where we have to go right now. Okay, so we're just gonna head straight over there. We're good to go, we are recording. And Edward, what are you doing? Sir, stop that, you're making a fool out of me. Thank you. All right, guys. Whew. So right off the bat, you can tell my ship's health, or the hull, what do they call it? The hull? The armor, let's just call it the armor, is significantly higher. We literally had 3 bars before, and I upgraded it, I think it was 2 or 3 times. I upgraded the cannons on the sides, a heavy shot. There are still several things we have to upgrade, but I feel like we're just, in general, so much better right now. Like, it is insane. The cannons are blasting off like crazy, a bunch of them at a time. Some of the cannons, not all of them, but some of them actually do a lot more damage. And it feels good that I can go against a level 37 man of war and honestly defeat them rather quickly. Versus before, I had to avoid that, you know? So, yeah, feels pretty good. Should upgrade your jackdaw before starting this mission. Okay, that's an insult. That is an insult. I'm sorry, okay? Spent 4 hours of my day upgrading this ship and... Fuck.
A great disappointment. His mind's made up to stay, he says. It's a sonny. And hang all of you lot that follow this sorry bastard into obscurity.
Faith in me is kind. But with Nassau done in, feel I'm finished.
I'm not of the same mind, mate. But I won't begrudge you the state of yours.
You still looking for that sage fellow?
Aye.
Taking a prize a month back, I heard a man named Roberts was working a slave ship called the Princess.
Might want to see about it. The Princess. Cheers, Thatch.
Well, don't sit there like a barrel of wet fish. We're celebrating my retirement! Uncork this man's breakfast!
Out! Save us a few bottles, eh?
The hell is that? Who is that guy? Why is he so sus, huh? What is going on here? Tale of the Stranger. Interesting. I'm gonna wait right here. Who is that guy? Should we label him familiar? I feel so good, dude. I'm not even worried about going to the seas right now. I feel good. Oh, what the hell?
What? Stay here. What? Shoot anything that moves.
Who was that? There was a deserter among them who recalled my face. I sliced into his gullet before any word left his lips.
Anybody see you? Don't think so, sir. But I reckon Kenway suspects something. He don't miss much.
Tell me about the beast.
Their gatherings. Most too drunk to stand.
That will suit our purpose.
Tell me about Edward Teach. What sort of man is he?
It's Thatch, sir. At least that's what he calls himself. But he's a mad bugger, he is. Cracked as a glass teapot, sir.
Details, man. Stop talking in here.
Well, sir, he likes his drink, for instance. Only he makes him queer. Takes the usual rum with it, fills it with half a weight of gunpowder to top it off.
I hear you were right. He drinks gunpowder?
Aye, sir. Just for show. And only last week, he rounded up a score of his crew. They had to sit in the hold of his shit while he burnt off sulfur and other sickening. He just sat there like it was one of a million pits of hell and nothing less ordinary.
Good God! What the hell for?
Like to test his crew is all. Tease out their fitness and what. Of course, it always turned out he was the fittest of the lot. Thought for a moment I'd die there. Bloody savages.
Have no fear, soldier. This will be the end of it. Come on. It's time. Quickly, send the signal. Remember always this day.
Oh.
What the devil?
Oh. Oh. God. Incapacitate the man of war. Okay. Okay, 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 okay. We got this. Come on. It's time to show off our new upgraded abilities. Ooh. we wouldn't have been able to do this if we wouldn't have upgraded it. Like, I had no idea this was coming. So I'm actually really happy that I spent 4 hours doing what I just did. Ah. No. Okay, we didn't sink it. Good. I was supposed to board it. Thank God. Thank goodness. Okay, kill the enemy crew. You see, so right now we have to do a lot more than normal, which is really cool. Okay, I'm gonna wait to get a little bit closer. Kill enemy officers. Just kill them right off the bat. Destroy enemies' powder reserves. Okay. The thing with the Man of Wars is they're so big that it's hard to use these. Yeah, it's hard to use these cannons on the side. Okay, I'm just gonna go straight to it. All right, let's get rid of this guy right here. Excuse me, partner. You scared of sharks? Oh, fuck. I didn't see him. Nice. Dude, I cannot believe. If I wouldn't have done everything I did today for the last few hours. Oh, what? Did you see that guy? Okay, glitch the fuck out. Oh. No!
In a world without gold, we might have been heroes!
Damn, what a quote, huh?
Not!
This is actually fucking sad right now. In a world without gold, we might have been heroes. Oh man, yo, that's fucking sad, dude. Oh shit. I'm about to cry. Fuck. No, chill. Alright, we gotta get out of here. I did not expect him to die. Yo, I don't... Bro, that's one of the most insane fucking quotes. In a world without gold, we might have been heroes. Dude, that is deep.
What a fat sir. Did he fall? Captain?
He drinks damnation.
Yo, I love this game, dude. I fucking love this game. This is the first time that the game really has given us some sort of emotional moment, and fucking hell. Oh, dude, what a... That was such a dope line. No, bro, fuck. Oh, shit, just got crazy. Oh. Okay, I'm gonna sound like a broken record, but that is an insane cool line, bro. And with the music in the background playing, is like, I gotta repair my armor. In a world without gold, we might have been heroes. Dude, like, if you let that sink in, it's like, dude, that's legit. That's deep. Inglorious bastards.
Your thatch has been topped. Oxai.
He was outnumbered. I couldn't reach him.
Devil damn the man, he was fierce, but his heart was divided.
It's hard to let go of the life you know best.
My own idiot father liked to brag about how he meant to purchase a ship of his own. I'll get a privateering contract, Charlie. Your old dad will be a captain. Drowned in a whiskey bottle before he ever left shore. Right, Kenway. I've been musing on this plan of yours. This observatory you're always going on about. How do we know it exists?
We find a slave ship called the Princess. Aboard should be a man called Roberts. He can lead us to it.
All them slavers work for the Royal African Company. Find one of their ships and start asking some questions.
All these missions are heavy on... Oh my god.
What's our course, Captain?
We're looking for slave ships. Any that work for the Royal African Company.
You don't mean to traffic human cargo now, do you?
No, Jesus, Annie. You know me better than that. We're only after information. Looking to find where the Princess docks in the spare time.
The Princess? A slave ship?
Right. Blackbeard told me there's a good chance we'd find the Sage aboard them.
Captain, Vince just sunk a merchant schooner.
Damn. Can't that animal stay the course we agreed to?
Douse the royals! Come! Mains out! Let's go!
All sails loose and stays tight!
Alright, so the mission's actually relatively close. I was gonna go and rescue that stranded sailman, but... just a bit too far. But as I was saying, dude, I'm so freaking happy that I did these missions to upgrade the ship, bro. Like, I cannot believe that this is pretty much what this episode's about. So far, this is one of my favorite episodes, even though it's only on the water, the majority. But the story, that's how the story has evolved suddenly from one episode to the next. You can see that this is already starting the downfall of our empire, pirate empire. I also want to see who does Edward meet? How does he have Haytham Kenway? You know, how does that occur? I don't know, dude. What is that ship over there?
It's there.
That's at level 29.
Don't sing that slaver ship, Kenway. There's hundreds of innocent men aboard.
I know.
Oh, so we got to board the ship.
There's sea critters to spare here.
Oh, dude, we can harpoon. Fuck. Okay, we'll do that next time. So we gotta fuck it up, but not completely, right? She spooked. Oh!
Fire! Fire!
Reload it, Captain.
You'll sink it if you're not careful. Get closer.
You gotta be very careful.
Fire!
Oh no, I hit the other ship. Fuck me. Oh, that's not good.
Fire!
Stay in the water. I'm taking us close.
Oh no.
Stay aboard, boys! Fast as you are! All clear, pull away!
Yo.
those bastards down, Kessler. I'll murder the man in scope myself.
Keep calm, Nathan. Remember what we're after.
Keep quiet before you got this. Those cannons have a long range.
I'll worry about the fort later on. I'm not even worried about that fort right now. Oh, we didn't heal up our. Oh shit, we didn't repair the ship. Okay, good. We can board it. We can repair it now though. So hopefully, if this works out normally, we're able to repair our ship. Here we go. Destroy the enemy ship flag. Kill enemy crew.
We're going over. Find the captain. Come on, Leroy says. You scare me back.
Guns and steel aren't louder than sticks and spittle, though.
I've more than enough of all that.
Just find the captain.
Sorry, bucko. Kill these guys here. Destroy the flagship. All the way to the top. Sayonara. This is exactly what I was talking about, that you could destroy the ship's flag. I didn't know they were going to make us do this as part of the mission, though. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. Alright, we're going to climb up through here. Gotta be very careful. Dude, look how beautiful this scenery is. Holy hell. Okay, now. I think we're dead. Good.
This captain claims the princess sails out of Kingston every few months.
All right. We'll set a course.
You made ash of my sails and rigging, jackanapes. You owe me a share.
Oh, damn it, Vane!
Oh, Charles, what a surly devil you are.
Don't fuck with me, Jack.
Oh, but it's my mandate to fuck with you, Charles.
Lads!
See, the boys and I had a bit of counsel while you were wasting time with this slot. And, well, they figured I'd be a fitter captain than you reckless dogs.
I'll cut you another cut, traitor!
This one I figure I might sell for a tenner.
Are you kidding me?
But with you two grog blossoms, I can't take any chances.
You regret this day, Rackham.
I regret most of them already. Tie them up! Cast them off.
Are you fucking kidding me, dude?
I'll gut you, Jack Rackham! I'll open you up, I'll tear out your organs, and strain your bloody loot with them!
Stop your goddamn howling, Vane! There's no bloody use!
Oh, well, well, the face of Edward Kenway speaks, eh? Pray tell us, Captain, how to quit this predicament. And tell us what genius you have for sailing a boat with no sails and no rudder.
Shut your gob!
Wow, dude. Well, bro, we backed square one. What?
Keep still now. I'll take these oysters you've ordered.
You mad sap. This island's crawling with food, if only you'd care to look for it.
Yeah, I am looking, louse. Found some just here. Don't come following now. Do you hear me? Don't come looking for me.
How long has it been? Did he go crazy?
Ratchet fool.
What has happened? Bro, we're losing. We've lost everything. Let me go sync up first. I love the color they use for the water in this game, dude. So beautiful. But yeah, we've lost everything pretty much right now, which is crazy. It's like we're back to day one. What the friggin' hell? I mean, I love it. For storytelling is awesome. For progression, not so much. Especially after I spent 4 hours. Dude, this is so crazy. I have a feeling we're gonna end up killing him. He's gone crazy. He lost his mind. That's insane, dude. Oh, here it is. We don't even have our sword. Are you kidding me? Isla Providencia. Guys singing. The only dude that was true to us was
Gold Ducks with the fishermen and their dories, Kenway.
Was Blackbeard.
This island's mine. Come at me, and I'll cap you, bastard! It was your bloody imagination that landed us here, Kenway! I'll be damned if I let that mind make one more decision for me!
Will you not talk to me, Vane? Are you fixed on this madness?
Madness? Nothing mad about a man fighting to survive, is there?
I mean you no harm, you corker! Now let's work this out like gentlemen!
Oh, God! I've got a bleeding headache on account of your jabbering. Now stay back and let me live in peace.
I would if you stop filching the food I gather and the water I find.
I'll stop nothing till you pay me back in blood. You was the reason we were out looking for slavers. And you was the reason Jack Rackham took my crew.
Oh, so he's not only gone crazy, but he's blaming us now. Well, that's not very nice, my friend. Hold on, let me grab this chest here. I'm only grabbing all the chests because I don't know if I'm ever going to come back to this island. Or maybe I won't grab all of them, but I'm grabbing the ones that I can practically see. Got that mine stone. Can we go back up through here? Yes. We can also sink up here as well. That's where he's at. Yep.
Vane!
What did he just do? Did he just dive? Crazy fuck. They should have made this game into a movie. This would be a really good movie with the right people involved. This would be a fantastic movie. Pretty fucking cool. So, I haven't seen the full trailer of this game. Oh. What the fuck? I don't have sleep darts either. Oh, I can't kill these fucking crocodiles. That would have been great. That would have been so, oh! That would have been so great. I would have been able to upgrade my gear.
I said not to follow.
Jesus, you've lost your head, man.
It's a fair exchange for finding these flintlocks and grenades.
Listen, Vane. We can hunt with those guns.
And I made so.
What a fucking crazy. Okay. Heal up, come on. Oh, this guy's stupid. He doesn't see me. Oh, never mind. Oh, he's gonna break that. He's gonna break that.
You and your bloody fairy stories got us into this mess, Kenway. And I'll be damned if I let you drag me into another.
You keep this up, and I'll have to kill you, Vane.
Bloody try, by all means.
Oh, shit. Oh shit, we're seeing animals here that we've been wanting to see for a long time. Not only just the crocs, but what is a leopard? Blackjack, a leopard. He's gonna blow that shit up, isn't he? Bro, what the fuck, dude? Let me see if I can get that black leopard real quick. Where'd it go? Boy, that's nope. That's not a leopard. Maybe I can actually, maybe I could get the guns from him and then probably come back and hunt the crocodile. Oh, shit. Come here. Come here, little kitty cat. Just wanna play. I wanna be pals. Come here. I'm sorry. Even if I had a knife, I wouldn't attack a leopard like that. I'm sorry. I would not. I could have crafted some darts, but I could have crafted some darts back there for the croc, I guess. But let me see. Hold on. Let me see if I can jump on top of the croc and assassinate it. No, I cannot. Never mind. All right, I'm spending too much time here. My bad. really bummed, dude. There's a lot of animals here. Fuck. Oh, there you are. Well, you're about to die.
Leaving this island alive, well, sir. Because I'm not going to sail again in a world cursed by your ugly boat.
Dude, you're an idiot. Might as well work together. They're going to kill you.
I'll flush you out.
Oh, come on.
Not dead yet. Here.
He's got no idea where I'm at.
You can't hide, Kenway!
You goddamn fucking knave, Vane!
Nancy boy! You only done half a fucking job.
Fucking hell. Is this my reward for believing the best about men? For thinking that a bilge rat like you could muster up some fucking sense once in a while. Maybe Horner Gold was right. Maybe the world does need men of ambition to stop the likes of you from mucking it all up.
Or maybe you just don't have the stones to live with no regrets.
Don't save me a spot in hell, Shanker. I ain't coming soon.
Air assassinate Vane. Damn. I didn't know that was part of the... This was a great, great chapter. Great chapter. We're back, as you can tell. Fuck.
Stealing a fishing schooner single-handed. Damn canny, Captain.
As is taking back my break from this pillock. Once again, I thank you both.
Nice.
This Billy Huff didn't last 2 months with your ship before he came limping back to Nassau. Took the pardon straight away.
I had to, lads. That Rogers was onto me from the first.
Hold your tongue, Rackham.
So what now? Still chasing your elusive fortune?
Aye, and I'm close. I've heard the Sage is sailing out of Kingston on a ship called the Princess.
Put your ambition to better use, Kenway. Find the Sage with us.
I've no stomach for you and your mystics, Mary. I want a taste of the good life. An easy life.
No one honest has an easy life, Edward. And it's aching for one that causes the most pain. All right, Rackham. Back to retirement.
The end is near, boys. The end is very, very near. It's so sad. I love this game so much. But I think that's it. I think that's going to be it for this episode. We just finished that sequence there and we lost a lot. We've gained some of it back, but we lost more than what we've gained. It was very unfortunate. But dude, that Blackbeard quote. Whew, that was awesome. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, drop it a like. And I hope to catch you guys on the next one.